One of my biggest complaints about Premiere Pro has always been the lack of GPU encoding on export. It always takes me 3 times longer to render anything in Premiere, even though I have a modern graphics card. Well, thankfully, the latest update to Premiere has added support for Nvidia hardware encoding, and the results are everything I'd hoped they'd be. Let's get undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
What's happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and I love it when a plan comes together. So first up, let's get the numbers out of the way, because I'm sure what you really want to know is how much faster it is. Well, I did a bunch of exports from different starting codecs, all rendering a 15-minute video, and here's what I got. Actually, I should mention that this video is sponsored by Nvidia, not by Adobe. Nvidia Studio is partnered with Adobe to bring this feature to Premiere Pro, but I have no monetary interest in Adobe. That being said, I am a big fan of Nvidia. I typically recommend their GPUs for video editing because of how well the NLEs that I use leverage their CUDA cores. The reason why I agreed to make this video is because I think it's only fair to show when a product improves the very things I've been complaining about. So credit where credit's due, because these results are very compelling. The green is the new NVENC hardware option, and the blue is the traditional CPU-only render. And as you can see by the timescale along the bottom, the NVENC exports are taking on average only 31% of the time the software encoder does, going from 17 minutes down to 5 minutes encoding raw, and from 12 minutes down to 3 minutes when doing an H.264 to H.264 export. And they're just as good in H.265, which is the other codec this update supports, seeing very similar time savings, on average from 15 minutes down to just over 4. And these results were using a somewhat modest system. For the CPU, I was running an i7-8700K clocked at 5 GHz, and the GPU is the Nvidia GTX 1080. And I should note that you'll need at least a 10 series graphics card or above to use this feature in Premiere, so a 10 series Pascal or a 20 series Turing card. More good news though is that you're also not really giving anything up for these increased speeds. I compared 6 different sets of exports and couldn't find any visual differences between them, and most importantly, the file size doesn't increase that much. It does get a little larger using NVENC, but only by about 5% on average, which is a tiny penalty to pay to save hours of your life. To put that into practical terms though, on a 15 minute export with a 24 megabit per second bitrate, you're going from 2.55 gigabytes on the software encoder to 2.69 using NVENC. And if you use H.265, you'll go from 1.71 gigabytes to 1.79, which like I said, is a very acceptable trade-off in my opinion. Now before this update, Premiere already had GPU accelerated effects and transitions, and those continue to exist. Anytime you see this little symbol next to an effect, it'll be accelerated. Just make sure you have the following options enabled. Under File, Project Settings General, make sure you're using CUDA GPU acceleration, and under Edit, Preferences Media, check off Enable Hardware Accelerated Encoding and Decoding. Also, I'm not sure if it's the latest update to Premiere or better GPU integration, but I found the timeline feels a lot smoother in this version than I remember. Let me know in the comments if you think so too. But to show you a comparison of how the timeline performs without CUDA acceleration, check this out.
Okay, so I've got a little test timeline here that has a few things going on. We've got a Blackmagic RAW clip, and then there's different clips over top of it. Some are H.264, some are DNX. And we have a text layer, and there's a color grade on all of them, but including this one. And the advantage is that Lumetri color, as you can see with the symbol here, is an accelerated effect. So when we have GPU rendering on, we can decode the file types that are supported by the decode. We can also accelerate our color grade, and also pay attention to the yellow bar along the top, which means that it's not rendered, but that it is playable. And that's going to turn to red when we take off the CUDA acceleration in a minute. And we also have this little green light here, which lets you know if there's any drop frames. It'll stay green if there's no drop frames, and it'll turn yellow if there are some. So let's just play it back and see. So we got text layer spinning, we got a color grade, and it'll cut to a different clip in a minute here. But as you can see, there are zero drop frames as we cut through. And we can scrub, and even if we scrub through and then say play it back here, it continues playing with no issues and still zero drop frames. But now, if we go up to File, Project Settings, General, and change it to Software Only, which disables the CUDA acceleration, now we can see that this bar turns red, and press play. Well, look how long it takes us to start playing, and immediately this turns yellow. 35 drop frames, 91 drop frames, 125, and you can see the text layer is having a heck of a time just trying to spin in place like that. And scrubbing through like this is brutal. It takes forever to sort of respond, and playback is nearly impossible.
Now, as far as configuring Premiere to use NVENC when rendering, in your export settings, choose either H.264 or H.265 for the format, which should allow you to choose hardware encoding under performance. If it gives you an error, you probably have something enabled that doesn't work with NVENC, such as 2-pass encoding. Just put that back to 1-pass, and you should be good to go. Here's the settings I use for my tests. Now, there are some other advantages I noticed during my testing. I didn't have a single render error when using NVENC, but I did have a couple when using software encoding. Of the 16 exports I did, 8 hardware and 8 software, 2 of them had to be repeated on the software side due to render errors or program crashes, one using H.264 and one using H.265. But with hardware encoding, I had no such errors. So not only is time saved in render minutes, but you're also going to be saving the time that you would spend on reopening the program and restarting the export. Now, this component is a lot more anecdotal since I didn't run hundreds of exports to give you proper fail rate numbers, but if you're someone who's had problems with rendering in the past, using NVENC with this update might alleviate some of those issues. Also, when using software encoding, Premiere just refused to render H.265 at the highest quality, and I had to drop it down to good to get it to export, where with NVENC, not only was I able to increase the quality all the way up to the highest setting and successfully render, but I also shaved 11 minutes off my export time. Pretty great. Also, for those of you that have gotten this far but aren't as into computers or editing and are thinking, that's all well and good, but what the hell is an NVENC anyway? Well, let's nerd out on that one for a minute. So first off, if you haven't seen my video on codecs, I highly recommend you watch that, because that'll go deeper into what H.264 is, and the differences between codecs and containers and so on. And that's important because NVENC is sort of an abbreviated brand name for NVIDIA's encoder, and you might sometimes see NVDEC, where the DEC stands for decoder, and encoding and decoding is a big part of video. In fact, codec is actually a portmanteau of coder, decoder, and details the form and function and possibly compression of your video stream. So when somebody says, what codec did you use, they're kind of asking, how is this file encoded, and how should I decode it? Now, when you try to play back a video that's heavily compressed or encoded in a sophisticated way, that can be taxing on your CPU. That process is the decode. And when you're finished editing and you want to turn your project into a shareable format, you'll have to encode it into a more manageable file, which again is something that your CPU is not the most efficient device for. You need your CPU to do so much already during your edit that also expecting it to completely handle these encoding and decoding tasks slows down your editing performance and leaves your GPU mostly unused. Which is silly, because NVIDIA GPUs are much better at performing these tasks than your CPU. And when utilized correctly by the NLE, they can work in tandem with your CPU to not only greatly improve your timeline responsiveness, but save you a lot of render time, as I showed in my graphs. And so it's a great day for Premiere users, because time is everything, and now you'll have more of it. But that's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video entertaining, or at least helpful, and if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, try setting the playback speed to 75%. All right, I'm done.